Hi everyone and welcome to this tutorial. In this video, we're going to be creating this similar animated scroll down icon with the help of Elementor free. You do not need the Elementor Pro, but we also have a tutorial on creating this same animated scroll down icon with Elementor Pro. So if you own Elementor Pro, follow the link to this tutorial and see how you can do it with the Pro version of Elementor. But in this tutorial, we're going to work with the Elementor free. It is absolutely beginner friendly, even though we're going to be using a tiny bit of custom HTML and CSS, but I'm going to explain to you every single step. So even if you have never had to deal with code, it is going to be super easy and fast for you. This icon is also going to be clickable, and it is going to send the user to a specific part of your website once they click on this icon. So there is a lot of types of creative scroll down indicators online on a lot of award-winning websites. They improve the user experience and help your visitors navigate across your website. And if you're looking for a beautiful and functional, professionally made website design for your web project, check out TemplateMonster.com, where you can find thousands of WordPress themes to any taste and suitable for any business niche. Or if you need WordPress themes or plugins in bulk, check out One by TemplateMonster, which is a subscription service. If you subscribe, you get access to over 10,000 of products that include WordPress themes and CMS templates, e-commerce themes, plugins, including Jet plugins for WordPress and graphics, presentation templates, illustrations, and a lot more. If you're interested, check out the links in the description. Now, let's finally proceed to our tutorial. And on your page in Elementor Editor, go to the Elements panel and look for the HTML widget, not the custom HTML with the WordPress logo. We need the other one. And let's drag it on our page. And in this field, what we need to do is to insert a code snippet, which I'm going to do right now. And I'm going to insert this same code snippet under this video in the description or in the comment section, so you can simply copy it and use it for your own project. So now I have made the interface a little bigger so you can see it better. And I'm going to now go over all of these values and over all of these lines. And I'm going to explain to you how you can customize this animation and what values you can adjust to make this animated icon look the way you want. So let's start from the very beginning. First, I'm going to show you how you can change the icon, how you can use a different icon. So I have used the Font Awesome website. You simply go to fontawesome.com and here in the field, just look for the icon that you want to use. I simply type in down and I want to use this icon. And now I went to the page of this icon and I have copied the HTML code. Simply click on it here and it copies it. Now I only need the name of the icon because I already have all the needed code. And I simply copy the name of the icon and I insert it instead of the name of the icon that has already been here. And as you see now, the icon has changed to the one that we have selected on fontawesome.com. Now let's see how we can change the size. Here you see the font size property. Pretty much this is the same thing that you see in Elementor when you change the size of your elements. And you simply type in the number of pixels which determine the size of the element. So the bigger the value is, the bigger the icon is going to be. And you can make it bigger, you can make it smaller, just changing the value, changing the number of pixels. So let's make it 50 pixels big. Then in the color, simply you can insert the hex color value. Now it is pitch black, but if we go and pick the color from the button, so I'll click on this button and I go to style. And this is actually the slider. This is the slider widget, which is a part of Jet Elements plugin. If you want to learn more about Jet Elements, I have left a link in the description, because it not only allows you to create complicated animated sliders, image sliders for your website, but it also features around 50 unique widgets for Elementor, but enough about Jet Elements. Let's insert the hex color code. So our icon has now changed color. So you see it is pretty simple to change the size and the color of your icon. And now let's actually see how we can animate this icon. These four lines in here. You see that the properties are a little different, but the values are the same. They repeat each other, and this is necessary for this animation to work in all of the browsers. So I have changed the name in one of the lines, but I now have to change it now in all of the other lines. The next value is the duration of the animation. And if you change it in one line, you have to change it in all of the other lines. The bigger the value is, the longer the animation is going to take. In our case, the animation is the start of the movement of the icon at its initial place, then it moves down by 40 pixels, and then it moves back up. And this is going to take 3 seconds in total. Then ease. Ease is the type of the interpolation of the animation. It means that the animation is going to be a little bit smoother than if it was linear, for example. With the ease type of interpolation, the animation is going to start slower, but then speed up to the middle of the animation and then end at a little bit slower pace, which is going to make it look a little better. Then infinite means that this animation is going to loop, it's going to be continuous. And if you want this animation to repeat a specific number of times, like say 5, you simply change infinite to 5. But if you change the value, as you remember, if you change the value in one line, you have to go and repeat it in all of the other lines. Because you want this animation to work the same and look the same in all of the browsers. Because your users might use different browsers. But for this tutorial, I'm going with the infinite type of animation. Now keyframes. Keyframes, you see here that the name also has to be the same as we have in the four lines above. So keyframes helps you imagine the timeline of your animation. Essentially, these 3 seconds start at 0%. So this is the beginning of your animation. And at the end of these 3 seconds, it's going to be 100%. And the middle of the animation is 50%. As you see, it starts at zero at its initial place, at its initial point, and then it moves 40 pixels down. When it reaches the 50% of the timeline, like at the middle of the animation, if you increase this value, it's going to move even further down. The amplitude is going to be bigger, so you can adjust this value to change the animation and customize it the way you like. And you can also make it faster if you change the duration of the animation to, let's say, 1 second. And it can also be crazy like that. But I'm going to get back to my values, which was 3 seconds and 40 pixels. And then at 100%, the icon gets back to its initial position where it has started at the beginning of the animation. So now this is pretty much it. When it comes to the custom code, we used a little bit of custom HTML and custom CSS for it, but now I want to make this icon clickable, and once the user clicks on the icon, I want the user to be sent to this specific part of my website, to this specific point where this section starts. What I need to do right now is to click on Edit section, go to Advanced, and go to the CSS ID field. Here I have to give an ID to this section. Let's call it scroll here. Now we need to copy it. I have copied this ID. I go to my icon again, and where you see the number sign, you have to replace this value that goes after the number sign. You have to replace it with the ID that you have given to your section. And now this icon is clickable, and it sends the user to this specific section right away once they click on this icon. Now, if you want to move this icon to some specific place, we could go to the custom position and change the width of this icon to inline, so the widget itself does not take up the entire width of the page, then we go to the position and select absolute. And now what we can do is to simply grab this icon and drag it to any place on our page. And I want to drag it here. So now once the user opens our page, they can see this icon right away and click on it and be sent to a specific place on our homepage. Now let's quickly go over the process of adjusting the position of this icon for the mobile devices. Since the position is absolute, it is going to jump to a different place if we switch to the mobile layout or to the tablet layout. Let's go to the tablet layout for now. And as you see here, now we have to adjust the position for the tablet layout as well. So now it's on its place when you switch to the tablet device. But if you want to hide this icon entirely, you can go to the responsive tab and you can choose hide on tablet and hide on mobile for this specific widget. So this is pretty much it for this tutorial on how to create this animated scroll down icon with Elementor free and a little bit of custom HTML and custom CSS. You can find the code snippet in the description under this video. I thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, leave us your thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more Elementor tutorials.